Here's Béliveau, out to Tremblay. Across to LaPointe. Shot kicked out by Johnson. Redmond blocked by Dallas Smith. He's upended, and we've got a penalty coming up to Boston's Dallas Smith. It looked like tripping John right in the slot.
Well, I'll tell you, the Bruins no sooner get one man out of the penalty box than one goes in, and there's Hodge going at LaRose here at center ice. They're both dropping their gloves. The linesman stepping in the way right here. Right below us, Mihaljevic comes off the bench for Canadians, and that'll draw a little fire, as we have more than the required amount of players on the ice from both teams. Now here's LaPointe and Cashman going at it at center. And Cashman can really throw them. They're both going at it toe-to-toe. Oh, and LaPointe caught Cashman a good right hand. And there's Sanderson now getting involved in there, and they're all coming off. Both benches are emptying. Even Cheevers is coming on. And we're going to have a Donnybrook right down below us here as both benches emptied.
Dan Kenny and John Forrestal clearing the entire bench of gloves and sticks. Ori and Lemire down below us. Well, trying to figure out who's paired off with who is rather difficult. Cashman, a bad gash on the right eye. And now another one breaks out. Right at center ice, it looks like from here, Ken Hodge. And Vachon piles on. Johnston joins in. Tremblay and Dallas Smith. Harper is involved. Hodge is in there.
Cashman's got a very bad gash over his right eye, but he wants to get involved in somebody here.
A good left hand by Cashman. Bailey's taking on two men. LaRose and McKenzie right down below us. I think it was Vachon that Cashman really clocked. And now Sanderson on the Montreal bench area as the Boston police step in. Fans getting involved. The player, I believe, is Phil Roberto. Sanderson being held by two Boston policemen. Right down below us at the Montreal bench area. There's Derek Sanderson right there. I think we ought to call in Don Dumphy, John.
Well, I don't know, Don. I think that naturally very unnecessary, certainly well out of hand, and you could see the feelings were running very high through this whole first period. Lots of body checking. There was a lot of stick work going on, slashing people's feet, and very unnecessary. I don't know if you could say, Ashley, let the game get out of hand.
There are those who say that this is the wildest fight that's ever erupted at Boston Garden. As you can see now, that's Phil Roberto, who strangely enough is the fellow that Derek Sanderson was fighting with on the ice and then in the Montreal bench area. The two of them, ironically enough, grew up together in Niagara Falls and have been good buddies for a long time. It does kind of swell over into the area of the fans. One fan caught a pretty good one that sent him down. Out of this whole thing came a total of 32 minutes of penalties. The two that were given to Dallas Smith for tripping, which started the whole thing off, and then there were three five-minute penalties on each side, three to Boston and three to Montreal. Let's go back now to Don Earl and John Pearson for more description of the rumble.
Both to the Canadians, and he's trying to break it up, but he's getting some rough treatment down there. And they're finally getting the players back on the ice. But I don't know how Ashley's ever going to make head or tail of this thing, because I'm as confused as anybody about Hodge started it, really, down there and at center ice. But we've got a problem now. The Boston police are around the Canadian bench. That's where the activity has centered over the last 5 or 6 minutes. And Roberto is pointing to somebody about something that happened while he was in the crowd fighting with Sanderson. Somebody from behind must have taken a swing at Roberto. But he and Cash, Sanderson and Don, I don't understand how Sanderson got over onto the Canadian bench to start with.
Well, this I can't figure out either, John, but when all of a sudden the ruckus started, there he was, right on the bench.
But it sure broke up the fights between the players in a hurry with that action going on behind the Canadian's bench with the Boston police involved in it. And now all the players are milling around. And it'll be some time now before this is straightened away. But if I were John Ashley, I think I'd suspend the 27 seconds left to play in this period and send the teams to their dressing rooms and start the 27 seconds at the start of the second period. I think that would probably be the smartest thing here. I think that we need a cooling off period, definitely. And right now is as good a time as any, as far as I can see.
It makes a lot of sense, John, because time does wonders in a situation like this, and I think both clubs could benefit from it.
There's Cashman. You just saw him go over in there. There's a right hand, left hand. He's got a tremendous left. The players were telling a funny story about Cashman with that left hand. They feel that he's going to throw the right, and he comes in with that sneak left. He's got a tremendous left hook, and he...